Alright guys, welcome to our channel Code with Sunny, and in this video I will be talking about the problem strange function of four forces round 729 division 2 CTAC. Actually this problem is really interesting, and this problem actually teaches us the new good concepts, how to handle the different case scenarios, the boundary condition and all that stuff. Okay, so let fi denote the minimum positive integer x such that x is not a divisor of I. Okay, so if we have been given some integer n, and fn is going to denote that what is the minimum positive integer x such that x is not a divisor of I. So suppose n is going to be like 8. You can see if we try to find out sequentially using brute force, let's say that 1 is a divisor of 8. Now it is 1 is a divisor of 8. Yes, so 1 is not our answer. 2 is a divisor of 8. Yes, so 2 is not our answer. 3 is a divisor of 8. No, so 3 is our answer, because 3 is the minimum positive integer. Minimum positive integer, which is not a divisor of n. Okay, so if we have been given some fn, we need to find the minimum x, which is not a divisor of I. Okay, so now for every test case we have been given some n, and we need to find the summation f of I, where I is going to vary from 1, and n is given in every test case. And if the values goes beyond this prime number, we need to take the modulus with this 10 power 9 plus 7. Okay, so you can easily see that what is the maximum value of n which is being given in every test case. You can see 10 power 16, and this is the very much used value. The brute force solution is obviously not going to be accepted within the time limit per test 1 second. So we need to find an efficient approach to solve this problem. And what is that efficient approach? Okay, so rather than going through the simpler way, we need to always try to think some problem in a reverse way. And what is that reverse way? Okay, so let me write down some integers so let me use this one. Okay, so let me click over here and let me write down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, 8, 9 and 10, let's say 11 also and 12 also. Okay, so let me bigger the size of this screen. Okay, so let me copy it down and increase the size. Okay, now you can see we have some integers from 1 to 12, and we need to find it out the summation. Let's say we have been given some n, and n is here 12, the maximum number, and we need to find it out summation I equal to 1 up to this 12, f of I, that is f1 up to f12. That is, now let us try to think in a reverse manner. If we have been given some, let's say some f6, we need to find the minimum positive integer x. Okay, what is the answer for this f6? You can easily see 1 is not, 2 is not, 3 is not, 4, yes, f6, answer of f6 is 4. Minimum positive integer which is not a divisor of I. 1 is a divisor, 2 is a divisor, 3 is a divisor, 4 is not a divisor. Okay, so let us try to think in a reverse manner. If we try to fix this x, okay, so if we try to fix this x, what are the different values of I within the range from 1 to n which is valid? Okay, so if we try to fix this x, what are the different values of I that are within the range from 1 to n? And if we know the number of values of I will just increment my answer as answer equals answer plus, let's say number of values are values into, I will just use the multiplication sign, plus, that is number of values into x, and the whole we need to take the modulus all over that. Okay, so let me repeat it once again. If we know the value of x, we need to try to find it out what are the different values of I within the range from 1 to n whose value, that is whose f value, function value f of I is exactly equal to x. And if we know the number of values, we can just increment our answer with values into x, that is number of values into my current value of x. Okay, so how to find this values term, that is number of values for a particular x efficiently? So let me write down, let me explain it a more clearer way. And what is that? Okay, so if we try to say that 3 is my answer, so if we try to say x is 3, it means that whatever the values of I that is going to give f of I as 3, we need to just try to find out the values of I. Okay, so let us focus over that. Whatever the value of I will come, that is, if x is our answer, whatever the value of I will come, I will be always being divisible by 1 and 2. That is the numbers that lie to the left of it. If I will say I am talking about x equal to 7, the value of I, that is the different values of I that I will get, will be that is all the values of I will be divisible by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to this one. That is 1 to x minus 1. Why this is happening? You can easily see x is the minimum positive integer which is not divisible by this I. Note that not divisor, which is not a divisor of I. If x is not a divisor of I and x is that minimum divisor, it means that all the values from 1 to this x minus 1 is going to divide the value of I. Okay, so that is something more interesting. We are just moving further to the solution, right? Okay, so if I will say that 3 is my answer, it means that for all the values from 1 to 2, you can see that for all the values of from 1 to 2, I is going to be divisible by 1 to 2. Okay, so let us find it out. What are the values that of I that is being divided by this 2? Okay, you can easily see 2 is being divided by I is being divided by 2. So I can be like 2. Note that I'm talking about this 2 right now. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and 12. Okay, so it means that I is being now divided by the values of 2, that is 2, 4, 6, 8, 12. Now if I will say that if 3 is my answer, it means that I should have to take the LCM of from 1 to 3. And if I will take the LCM of 1 to 3, I will just say that number of values, that is this term, will be n divided by LCM of 1 to j minus 1 minus n divided by LCM of 1 to j. If you are not going to understand this term, no need to worry about. Let us understand this term, that is this whole complex term, in a much more clearer way. So let's move further. Okay, so if you focus over one thing, that is what I have written over this first term and this second term, is that the first term is going to denote that whatever the values that is being divided by for all the numbers from 1 to j minus 1. Okay, so let us take a small example to understand this. So what I've written for this, for x equal to 3, LCM from 1 to j minus 1 and n is 12. So you can see the values that I am going to be picked up by first term is like 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and 12. That is for all the values of I. Note that these are the values of I where these values of I is being divided by 1 and 2. Okay, now let us focus over the another thing, that n divided by LCM from 1 to j. Now the LCM from 1 to j is coming out to be 6. So my second term will pick up the value from 6 to 12. Okay, so if you focus over one thing, that is the subtracted value, that is from all these values I have subtracted the value of 6 and 12. It means that this value is being discarded, this value is being discarded. Now this 2, 4 and this 8 and this 10 remains. You can easily see that 2, 4, 8, 10, the values that are being remained is to this, these values, and these all values have the value, that is f of I is exactly equal to 3. You can just check it out. F2 is 3, F4 is 3, F8 is 3 and F10 is also 3. Okay, so how this is giving the correct answer? You can easily see that whatever the values of I that is being divisible by from 1 to j minus 1. First, I have taken this value and I have just removed those values which are being divisible by the current jth number, that is current x number, that is I am talking about this x. I have just removed those values. Note that I have taken the LCM from 1 to j here and 1 to j minus 1. If I have, that is 1 to j, now this 3 is included. And if I am able to remove all the those values of I which is being divided by this current number 3, that is the x, it means that whatever the number that is being remained is going to give the minimum positive integer as x, because we have just removed all the entries which is being divided by the number x. Okay, now the one again doubt, why I have taken this LCM term? Okay, so it means, okay, so if you talk about a certain number, let's say 7, and you want this as your answer x, it means that all the numbers from this one must be first divisible by, that is we need to find the number of values. It means that n divided by the number of values which is being divided by, that is all the numbers from 1 to j minus 1 must be a divisor of this n. It means that we need to take the LCM from 1 to j minus 1, not the product. First, I am also, when I was solving this problem, I have just also taken the product, which was actually wrong. So we need to take the lowest common multiple from 1 to j minus 1, and we need to find the number of satisfactory values of I. Then we are going to remove those values of I, not the those values of those values of I which is being divided by the current value x. You can easily see. So how to remove that value? I need to take the LCM for the current number also. So here I will take a j minus 1. Here I have taken this j. And if I have removed these values, you can see I have got the number of values of those, that is number of satisfactory values where x is going to contribute as answer. So if you have not got gotten one more thing, let us take another example. Short example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. Okay, so let's say I am going to say that 4 is my, that is x equal to 4. And we need to find the number of satisfactory values of I, f of such that f of I is 4. So what I am going to do is, let's say n is 12. I will first find out LCM of this 1, 2, that is 1, 2 and 3. So what is coming out? 6 by, you can easily see the LCM is coming about to, LCM is coming about 6, 12 by 6 is 2. And if I will subtract the value of this one, that is LCM from 1, 2, 3 and 4, you can easily see the LCM is coming about to whatever, I think 12, yes, 1. So it means that if you subtract this value, so this value is 2 and this value is the 1. So f of I is coming out 4 in 1 to 12 in exactly 1. That is number of values of I that will satisfy this relation from 1 to 12 is exactly 1. You can just check it out first. Okay, so let us move further to the coding part to analyze how we are going to do that. Okay, so you can see I have written the code over here. So first I have taken n and I have also written the base case is n equal to 1. Now my answer is 0. I need to find the contribution of every number. Note that this thing I is less than equal to 42. I need to iterate up to 42. And now again this common doubt, why 42? Okay, so if we try to find out the LCM up to this 42, you can see that is if you try to I am just dividing the using the in the denominator part the LCM. So if LCM is going to exceed the maximum number 10 power 16, then it is of no use. So if you try to just get that value, what is the maximum value after which this LCM is going to exceed the 10 power 16 value, you can get the value as 42. So I have just iterated up to 42 because after that value, it is of no use. Okay, so you can see I have taken this previous n by LCM, just I have modified this LCM, then I have taken the current LCM. You can easily see I have just taken subtracted previous minus current. Previous is basically the n divided by LCM of from 1 to j minus 1. Then I have taken this LCM with the current number. Now it becomes LCM from 1 to G. So it becomes now as denoted as current. So previous minus current, modulus this number because it may exceed the value of that prime number. Now I have just incremented my answer with this one. And finally print the answer for every test case. So if you have any doubts, do let me know in the comment section of the video. And I will ask the viewers to like this video, share this video, and do subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you for watching this video.